Welcome back, folks, to another episode of Firewood Doctor. It's April the 8th, and I'm going to be working on the split in the wood that I cut up in the last two videos. It's a bit windy, as you can see. My hair is just blowing in the breeze. A little snowy, could be a little sleet. At least it's not raining. That's what I'm telling myself. At least it's not raining. So, splitters all warmed up. Let's get splitting. The first batch of wood I'm going to be splitting is this one, just so I can have room to stack this wood over here. So this is the wood cut up by the 572 XP, I think, or is it? I'd have to check. Anyway, get the splitter fired up and get going. I just checked this big pile is the 572 XP. That little pile is from the Echo 590, and I got a bunch of rounds from that to do yet, so I'm going to have to bring those over and split those up so I can see exactly how much I got from that tank of fuel. It's been on-off snow like this all afternoon, and sometimes it hasn't been doing anything, and other times it's been coming down pretty good like this. I did a couple hours of splitting already. It's speeding up now that when I hit the drier wood, so I don't have to split as small, which is really nice. That really cranks things up. As you can see in some of the footage, if you've been watching closely, a few people commented, "Why do you let your splitter return all the way?" Hell, I've been trying to do that. Stop it short of full retraction, especially when I'm setting up to do the four-way split. So that's really helped, taking a few seconds off each split. But man, this wood is just piling up the debris. I'll show you what I'm going on about. It keeps piling up in there every few splits. I gotta clean it out. So a push through wedge splitter like the Wolf Ridge or Easton Bands would take care of that issue. But man, I got a lot of debris here. And this is part of the mystery wood that I had a video short of. That definitely looks, that looks like hickory to me once it's opened. I got a few pieces in there. I'll do the confirmation split in another video. So yeah, it's going good. That's all I got left from the tank of the Echo. I piled up all the pieces except that one. I missed that one. I'll grab that one, and then that's all that's left from that 95% tank of fuel in the Echo now to get splitting and finish this job. to show you the carnage and the wood pile. This wood pile is about 4.5 feet tall. It comes out about 8 foot to here, and it goes all like 10, 12 feet. And so it's pretty good sized. So that is 3 hours of splitting with breaks, probably a half hour break. So it probably took me 2.5 hours to split that. I was splitting a lot of it early on as very, very small pieces because it just felt so wet. So I had to split it small to make sure it dries. And that was a good afternoon's worth of work. I got done early with work, and so I figured, well, I'll get some work done in the wood yard. So tomorrow is going to be stacking this, maybe as my warm-up. Get that stacked to find out how much there is. There's probably close to a cord there. It's got to be close. That was a 95% of a tank of gas. There wasn't much, just barely enough to see it in the tank when I jiggled the saw. So, and then I'll be going on to splitting this pile after I get that stacked. So until next time, folks, take care. Get out there, do something. Have fun doing it.